Hello and welcome back to TechFab YouTube channel. So today in this video we are going to fix VC runtime 140.dll error in Windows 7, 8 and 10. So let's get straight to the video, and I would like to advise you that the cause of this error is because you are trying to open an application or a software but the DLL file for the particular software is either deleted or corrupted. So this is the reason you are getting this error. Now let's try to fix it and open any of the browser whatever you are using and click on the URL bar and paste the link, and I have already provided the link in the description. So just go there and copy that link, paste there, and after that click download. So in one click you are going to download the file here, and once the file will be downloaded it will take approximately a couple of seconds to couple of minutes, so you need to wait. Now you can see that the zip file has been downloaded. What you need to do is you need to extract the file. I have just opened the folder and right click there, and I will cut it and I will paste it in my D drive, and I will make a new folder there, new folder 2, and then I will paste it there. So you don't need to do that. If you just want to extract there, you can extract, and after extracting you need to click extract here and you will get the folder. And here we go. So this file will work for 64-bit operating systems and this file will work for 32-bit operating systems. You need to check which version you are using, and if you don't know how to check it, just go onto the main screen and click on my computer, go into the properties, and under the properties it will take approximately a second time. So now it's now running. So here we go, system type, you will check if it's 64-bit, if it's 32-bit. Now I have the 32-bit, and what you need to do is you need to go back and go on there. So I have 32-bit, I will click there and I will install the software, run it as administrator and click yes. And now you just need to agree and follow the steps, and it will take approximately a couple of minutes, and once it will complete the installation, and then go back, check your software, check your program which was giving you the error. And but before you can open that application or a software, I will recommend you to restart the computer once, so that your computer will be applicable to pick this C++ program, and then you can use your application without any problem. So that was the video for today, and I hope you enjoy the video, and if it's working for you, kindly subscribe us and like the video. I will see you in the next video. Till then, goodbye.